Hello kids, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. Children, as you all are aware that we were doing revision of a GK book, and in that row today we are going to revise our page number 36 and 37, that is festivals and fun. So children, as you all can see on the board, this topic, that is festivals and fun. So children, nowadays there is a time of festivals, although this year we are not celebrating festival with that much happiness, because this is the time of such kind of a pandemic that we all are going through it. And children, basically festivals, when we will be having time of festivals, we were enjoying that time, we were playing, having fun, talking to our friends, talking to our relatives, meeting different people, and all these activities bring happiness to us. So that is your festivals and fun. Now festival is, nowadays also we are celebrating many festivals. In the month of October, we have celebrated Dashera. After that, that is followed by Diwali. Then we have Christmas, and then New Year, and then Holi, and all, so many festivals were there. Now our country, that is India, is known as land of festivals. Why? Because many different community people, those who are living here, they are allowed to celebrate their own festival in their own way. So that commitment was given, or that independence given to each community, and they can celebrate their own festival in their own way. Though they don't require any permission from anyone, they can celebrate their festival. But why do we celebrate festival? Festival means that one fine day, whatever will be happened, that will be happened in the form of a festival. Like that, when Sri Ramchandra ji has killed Ravana on 10th day of that Navratra, so that is celebrated as Ram the Vijaya Dashmi. Actually, we are calling it Dashahara. Dash means Dashanan. Dashanan means Ravan. Ravan Hara means when Ravan defeated. So that is your Dashahara. Or Vijayadashmi. Vijayadashmi means the 10th day when Lord Rama got Vijay. Vijay means Jeet jab unko mil gayi thi. Theek hai? वो जब रावण के ऊपर उन्होंने जीत हासिल कर ली, तो दैट डे वाज सेलिब्रेटेड एज विजयादशमी. एंड देन वी हैव दीपावली. दीपावली अगेन व्हेन लॉर्ड रामा केम टू अयोध्या आफ्टर किलिंग रावणा, देन दे हैड थॉट कि अयोध्या में जो रहने वाले लोग थे, लॉर्ड रामा केम ऑन अमावस्या when no moon day was there, so the people, those who are living in Ayodhya, they had a thought, okay, we'll light up Ayodhya with diyas only, so that when our king will come, Lord Rama will come, they will be happy looking at all. So like that, after, behind each festival we will be having such a long story. So that today's session we are going to continue with the name of the festival, what are the different features, as well as if we will having a short story, or I'm going to explain all these festival with a short story. So I'm going to tell that short story also along with that festival. So first of all, we'll start with the first one, read the clues and name the festival. First one is, on this day we celebrate the homecoming of King Mahabali and we enjoy watching the snake boat races. We also eat delicious food. So what are the different things? That this day is celebrated as homecoming of King Mahabali. Now there is one interesting story about King Mahabali. Actually, what happened, that King Mahabali was very often giving daan dete the, and then they were giving away paisa also and everything, and he was very proud of himself ki wo unko to sab kuch, they can do each and everything, they can fulfill dreams of anyone. Unko wo dheere dheere us cheez ka proud hone lag gaya tha. So one day Lord Vishnu had thought ki okay, I'll go to Mahabali king and I'm going to ask for something which he could not give, so that their proud or their pride will be broken. So proud, because वो बहुत उनके अंदर अहंकार आ गया था, अहंकार आ गया था, तो अहंकार को तोड़ने के लिए फिर जो लॉर्ड विष्णु थे, दे टुक रूप ऑफ वामन, दैट इज ब्राह्मणा, एंड देन गो टू देयर किंगडम, एंड आफ्टर टेकिंग बाथ महाबली केम आउट फ्रॉम द रिवर एंड दे स्टूड इन फ्रंट ऑफ दैट किंग महाबली एंड सेड, किंग I want something, can you please give me? So king has said, king Mahabali has said, yes, I'll give you. So वो जो वामन अवतार में विष्णु भगवान आए थे, उन्होंने बोला I want 3 feet earth, मुझे 3 पग धरती चाहिए. So महाबली, किंग महाबली had a thought, okay, इसमें क्या कौन सी बड़ी बात है, you can take that, आप ले लीजिए, आपको 3 पग जमीन चाहिए, why should you, आप और कुछ ले लो, 5 villages ले लो, कुछ ले लो, यू कैन टेक सम किंगडम ऑल्सो. बट ही सेड नो, आई वॉन्ट ओनली 3 feet और 3 feet अर्थ. सो फाइन, उसने एग्री कर लिया, महाबली ने एग्री कर दिया, ओके फाइन, व्हाट डू यू, वट एवर यू वॉन्ट यू कैन डू इट. सो आफ्टर एग्रींग दैट महाबली, वामन अवतार में जो विष्णु आए थे वो बहुत बड़े 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 होने लगे, और इतने बड़े हो गए कि व्हेन दे ही केप्ट 1 feet, तो पूरी 1 feet में उनके पूरी धरती आ गई, 1 पग में पूरी धरती आ गई. देन ही केप्ट 2nd pug, मीन 2nd feet, तो 2nd feet में उनके पूरा आकाश आ गया. एंड 3rd feet उन्होंने बोला नाउ नो स्पेस इज लेफ्ट, वे शुड आई कीप इट. तो किंग महाबली हैज गॉट द लेसन, ही सेड कि ओके भगवान प्लीज कीप योर फीट ऑन माई हेड. और ऐसे करके वामन अवतार में जो विष्णु आए थे, दे गेव मुक्ति टू द किंग महाबली, एंड दैट किंग Mahabali has came again in the kingdom in another room, and that is your homecoming of King Mahabali, that is there. And this festival is celebrated as Onam in Kerala, Onam with this name Onam, and snake boat race is quite common over there in that festival. Second one is, on this day we celebrate the birth and death anniversary of our Sikh gurus. We go to Gurdwara, do our prayer and to our gurus. So that is what, that is Gurpurab. That is what, that is Gurpurab. Gurpurab. Now, what does this name means? Gurpurab means, Gur stands for Guru. Purab means which shows directions. Ki wo Guru jo kisi ko directions dikhata, that is your Gurpurab. So that is there only. Gurpurab means one who shows the directions. That is Gurpurab. So on that day, this festival is a common festival of Sikh people. They go to Gurdwara, that is their place of worship, and they do and a prayer in front of their Guru Granth Sahib. And Guru Granth Sahib is the holy book. Okay children, now one more thing. You have to learn holy book of each religion. Fine. So each religion means holy book of Hindus is Ramayana, Mahabharata, and then of Gurdwara or Sikhs is Guru Granth Sahib, of Muslims is Quran Sharif, and of Christianity is Bible. So Guru Parv or Guru Purab. Guru Parv, most of the time you have heard from a few of the children, a few of the person also, that is called Guru Parv. Guru Parv, the Parv means festival. The festival of Gurus is called Guru Parv. Now third festival that is very interesting festival of children, that is Ho Ho Ho. I visit children with gifts and chocolates on this day every year. That is your Christmas. Santa Claus, Christmas. Now Santa Claus come to different home and then he is distributing different gifts. Even though their parents are giving gifts to the children to enjoy their day. Now the next is fourth one is, this is the festival of lights. We light diyas and candles on this day. So that is your Diwali festival. Just now we have celebrated, and on this Diwali I am very much sure that no one of you have used that pataka and all, because that was banned this time in Varanasi. And hopefully you all have followed that rule and you have not used it. And Diwali is also only known as festival of lights. That is also important. Diwali is only known as festival of lights. So which of the festival is known as festival of colors? That is your Holi. So Diwali is known as festival of lights. Now we'll come to fifth one. One a tidbit is given on that page number 36, that is the Jewish festival Hanukkah is observed for 8 days and 8 nights. So that is Jewish people, they celebrate this Hanukkah festival, which is there for 8 days and 8 nights. So now we'll come to fifth one, that is on this day we give food and money to poor people. We break our month long fast on this day. So this is the festival, that is your Eid. And Eid is again a festival which is celebrated by Muslim people, and they offer prayer in front of their God and they give food and money to the poor children or poor people. Whatever they required, they'll give them. And this is one of the way to celebrate this festival. So that is very important that you all will remember number 5. And that is Ramzan or Roza. That is called month long fast of Mohammedans or Muslims is, that is Roza. Now we'll come to sixth picture, that is we buy new clothes for this festival. The best part is the yummy food. We celebrate this festival for 4 days. That is what? That is Durga Puja. Now Durga Puja, Durga Puja. Now Durga Puja is also celebrated with Dashera. So on the 7th day, this Ma Durga ideal, Ma Goddess Durga ideal will be placed on a specific pandal or that specific place. And the people, those who specially belongs to Bengali community. Because this festival, that is Durga Puja, is a quite common festival of West Bengal. Bengali people, they often find this day or celebrate this Durga Puja. See children, these festivals which we have done today, few of the festivals are common festival which was celebrated by all the community, but few of the festival that is celebrated particularly on a particular day by a particular community, like Durga Puja. Durga Puja is a common festival of Bengali people. So that festival is celebrated in the West Bengal as well as nowadays we were celebrating it. अपने वाराणसी में वी विल फाइंड इट आउट दैट हाउ मेनी प्लेसेस और हाउ मेनी पीपल दे वर सेलिब्रेटिंग विद दिस दिस दुर्गा पूजा. सो ऑन दिस डे दे बाय न्यू क्लोथ्स, दे ईट गुड फूड एंड वी सेलिब्रेट दिस फेस्टिवल फॉर 4 days. सो दैट इज देयर, दैट इज दुर्गा पूजा. वेलकम टू 7th. This day marks the arrival of spring season. We celebrate it with colors. So what is that day? That is your Holi. Holi is celebrated as a colors festival of colors. Holi is also known as festival of colors. And many of them were enjoyed this festival, will play Holi among each other, and then we enjoyed this festival of colors. Although our India is again a country which is known as land of festivals, so that again Holi is a festival. Now Holi symbolized that now spring season is coming. Now we'll come to 8th one. This is a harvested festival celebrated to thank the sun god. We celebrate this day with food and flowers. So that is what festival? That is your Pongal. 8th one is Pongal. So instead of Pongal, you can remember that there are the different harvest festival. If I'll go in Punjab, there the harvest festival is Lohri, Baisakhi, and few more festival in that festival Lohri will come. So that is not. And from south, if I talk about Tamil Nadu, then there we will be having this Pongal as a harvest festival. So children, with this we have finished all the 8 festivals which have been given in your book. Now one more story I want to tell you, that is related to I'll revise it once and then I'll. King Mahabali story I have told you. Christmas again, birth anniversary of Jesus Christ. Diwali again, pathake hum chalate in the supervision of our mother, father and all. So that is an important. Eid again. And this Pongal. In Pongal, it is a harvested festival and that is used for thank God. Now we celebrate the day with food and flowers. So food and flowers will be used to decorate that particular place. Now in China, there is a lantern festival. Lantern festival, that is houses are decorated with colorful lanterns. Now often with riddles written on them. Now what do they do? This lantern festival is celebrated in China, and one who hang that lantern outside their houses, they will write a riddle, ek paheli us pe likh dete, and one who come in their houses, they have to give answer. If they will give, they will get money, prize or something like that. So that is again an interesting festival from China. That is your tidbits. So I hope children, you do not have any doubt in this festival. I'll revise all these festival as well as I'll tell you few of the certain festival like Navratri. Just now you have heard about Navratri. in Navratri, that is a festival of 9 days. Navratri is the festival of 9 days, and people, they were celebrating whole 9 days. At the night they were doing garba and all, and next day they will be having a fast of that 9. So first day, that all the ceremonies that is related to the festival, that will be done, and from the next day they were going in that garba area or garba ground, and they were doing garba and all. So now children, these festival now will come to next. Harvest festival of south is Pongal, and harvest festival of Punjab is Baisakhi. On Baisakhi, now when Baisakhi is celebrated, Baisakhi is celebrated on in April. Fine, that is celebrated on 13th of April. 14th April is the birth anniversary of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. On 13th April, you were celebrating that Baisakhi. So Baisakhi is a festival, harvest festival, which is celebrated by a community of people that comes in Sikhism. So if they are living in village, then they are cutting their some part of that field and then putting in the feet of God, and then later on they will cut the whole feet. So quite important festivals are these. First of all, Onam. Onam is a festival or that is known for the homecoming of King Mahabali. Homecoming of King Mahabali, and we enjoy watching the snake boat race also. So in this Onam, you will remember that snake boat race will also happen over there. And Kerala is the place. Kerala, where do we celebrate this Onam? Then state also you will remember, that is Kerala. Now Guru Purab. Guru Purab, which is also called Guru Parv. Guru Parv, G-U-R-U-P-A-R-V. Guru Parv. And this actually, it never happens that on that particular day when you will born, like I am born on that particular day, on that same day you will die also. But it happens with the Guru Nanak Dev Ji, which is the first guru of Guru Parv, Sikhism. So what do they do? They will give them a lesson to move with all the rules and regulations of Sikhism. So children, so they offer prayers to their Sikh gurus, and their birth and death anniversary is celebrated in this festival, that is Guru Purab. Now the third is that Santa Claus come to the children and offering gifts to them. Even though we all are knowing that Santa Claus are not real, but though the smaller children, they are waiting for Santa Claus, then the most of the parents were doing, they were giving gifts, and then they are saying that yes, the Santa Claus has came. Now Diwali, next is the festival, that is Diwali. Diwali is a festival which is called Festival of Lights. And why it is called Festival of Lights, the story behind that I have told you. And today we have taken short stories also related to that festival. That also you will remember why this festival is celebrated. That is also again an important thing. So Diwali is celebrated when Lord Rama came to Ayodhya after the death of Dashanan or Ravana. Then Jewish festival Hanukkah is observed for 8 days and 8 nights. Next is, that is of your tidbits. Now we'll come to next page, that is Eid. Now, Eid is a festival of certain community. They were break their month-long fast, that is Roza, right? They have that Ramzan ka mahina, and they will not eat during sun. जब तक सन रहता है, दे डज नॉट ईट एंड दे विल ओपन देयर फास्टिंग और देयर फास्ट आफ्टर सनसेट. सो दैट इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट वन. एंड ईद इज मेनली सेलिब्रेटेड बाय दे विल ईट सेमिया एंड दे विल एंजॉय वे स्वीट्स, खजूर, फेमिया एंड डिफरेंट डिशेज विल बी अवेलेबल इन द मार्केट. दे एंजॉयड दिस फेस्टिवल विद देयर फ्रेंड्स, विद देयर रिलेटिव्स. They meet each other, they talk to each other, they wear new clothes, they offer clothes and food to the poor children or poor people. So that is a festival. As this Eid is a festival of spreading happiness to the people, those who do not have it. So now we'll come to sixth one. Durga Puja is an important festival of West Bengal. The people, those who are living in West Bengal, they were celebrating Durga Puja. But nowadays, Durga Puja is celebrating in rest part of the country also, rest part of our India. Durga Puja in this on the seventh day of Navratri, this goddess, Lord goddess Durga, ideal will be kept on in an open area. And then that goddess Durga will be prayed for the next 4 days. After that, there is Durga Puja will there is ideals of Durga Ji was submerged in the water. So that is your Durga Puja. Mostly earlier time, this Durga Puja was celebrated in West Bengal only. But nowadays, you will find it out that this Durga Puja is celebrated in many part of your country. Now seventh one is Holi. Holi is known as festival of colors. Mainly it is a symbol of upcoming of spring season, and children enjoyed this festival a lot because they love to play with colors, water, balloons and all. Different pichkaris and all will be there in that Holi, and different dishes have been made or cooked in the houses also, gujia and all, and many different dishes will be there for the people. Now we'll come to eighth one, which is a harvested festival. This is a harvest festival celebrated to thank the sun god. We celebrate this day with food and flowers. Actually, what happened in this Pongal festival, they will cultivate their new crop, and of that crop they will harvested crop will be kept in the feet of God Sun and given to that goddess Sun, and all these things will be decorated, and they later on they will cook that rice, and that rice will be taken as a food, taken as a blessings of God Sun. So with this antidotes again about Lantern Festival, which is celebrated in China. They were writing riddles on that. And if you will solve those riddles, you can will be getting a small gift. So that is your page number 36 and 37. That is festivals and funs. So children, you all will read this, and the stories behind different festival that also I have told you. Now children, I'm going to finish the class. You all will revise this page number 36 and 37. So children, we are going to do many more things in our online class. So I hope you all are enjoying online class. And that's all for today, children. Take care of yourself. Have a nice day.